This is Coleman. He loves beefing things up and watching them explode. This is Pagey. He's a motor mouth with an eye for detail. And their wits, brains and talents are about to be tested in a classic face-off. It's early Saturday morning, and these two amateur inventors are about to be given another boring, bland household appliance. They have 48 hours to try and make it bigger, better, faster, and stronger.
Toasters.
Yep. You can take everything from my kitchen, except you have to pry my toaster from my cold, buttery fingers. Seriously, it's all I could live on toast. The standard domestic toaster is a device that has been designed to waste a man's precious time.
True that.
It simply shouldn't take that long to transform bread into toast. You have the weekend to make a bigger, better, faster, stronger toaster. On Sunday, you'll be challenged to see who can cook and eat four slices of toast in the fastest time.
There's the key.
That's double the daily intake of toast.
That's the bottleneck right there.
Be aware that blackened toast is a known carcinogen. Good luck.
It's time for Pagey and Coleman to choose some team members. Each one possesses a skill set that will be handy for the build. Except one, the wild card, whose line of specialty is not at all helpful. This week, there is a coach builder, a mechanic, a construction worker, an electrical technician, and the wild card, a life coach.
I choose you.
Chose the girl.
Absolutely, like to have balance in my ship. All right, mechanic.
Mechanic.
My name is Kendall Coleman. I'm not related to James in any way, and I am a qualified mechanic.
I want this man. He looks like he knows what he's doing. Let's see. Life coach.
Tend to specialise more in helping people let go of limiting beliefs and dissolving negative feelings.
You've got a grin that I can't beat, so come on up, mate. Nice. Electrical technician.
I've been in the electronics and electrical line for the last 30 years.
Is that your dad? I'm choosing Pagey's dad. I mean, it's your dad. Looks like you. Maybe it's you in about 20 or 30 years.
Sorry, Dad.
Maybe 10. Coach builder.
And life coach.
Have a life
Very
coach
Very good.
Builder.
Welcome to Team Coleman.
I can basically build anything out of steel, aluminium, and I believe that that's going to help our team with whatever design we come up with.
Well, we'll see what we missed out on, eh? What do we got? Oh, construction worker. Could have done with construction worker.
Yeah. Pagey. Alrighty. Good luck, mate.
Good luck.
Good toasting.
The teams retire to their sheds, ready for their weekend of building. An average piece of bread takes about 2.5 minutes to toast. They need to make something that can cook toast faster than this, and then nominate someone from their team who can eat it even faster.
Big heat. We need big heat.
Yeah. Big heat. Big heat. Big heat.
Yeah. Yeah.
And a lot of it.
Why don't we use gas?
Cool. Fire. Sounds good to me.
So that's basically what you find in a light bulb in there, eh?
Pretty much, yeah.
Reckon we could, like, use the lights to, like, cook bread with it?
No reason not.
Eh? Yeah.
Here we go.
We're going to cook one at once or four at the same time?
Right, I don't know.
Let's what do you reckon? Let's put a magazine on. Let's load it up.
Magazine?
Magazine.
Yeah.
Shoot it up.
Oh, yeah. So you've got kind of like an action where you, one toast goes in and then somehow we get the thing to reload another piece of toast, bang, 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 and they come out the other end. Love it. Love it.
Put the jets, these jets here, they come one here and maybe one here.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe something like that.
Yeah.
And they kind of shoot flames.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
This way.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and yeah. That, big fire.
Yeah, lots of fire.
Yeah, yeah.
Coleman's team will create a bolt action burner. Two LPG burners will blast enough heat to cook the toast instantaneously. A magazine will feed individual slices into the cooking zone via a bolt-action system. Once the bread is cooked, the bolt-action will eject the toast, allowing the next piece to be loaded for toasting.
What if we had our bread as one slab and we just went,
Pagey's team will use the radiant heat from light bulbs to cook toast. Radiant heat is the secondary heat created by something as it performs a primary task. Multiple light bulbs will be used and mounted in a frame, creating a larger heating area, enabling them to toast all four pieces of bread at once. A catapult holding the toast will flick out the yeasty squares onto a plate for eating. Time once more for the teams to write up a list of things they need to get for the build.
I have no idea what that is. Some kind of deep fryer grip thing. Probably some butter as well, eh?
Oh, yeah, please, lots of butter.
You can drive? Sure. Got a clean license?
Good.
Let's go.
Andre is out first for Paige's team.
Just crank it.
Excellent.
All right, let's go, eh?
But Coleman's team isn't far behind, and 10 minutes later, Murray leaves with specific instructions from Coleman.
Get plenty of gas. Get some bread!
While they wait for the parts to arrive, Paige and Kendall start the important process of determining who will be quickest at eating the toast.
I reckon I could totally get that all that in my mouth in one go.
You reckon? I think I'm going to challenge.
While Coleman marvels at his uncanny lookalike.
That's uncanny. Yeah.
Give you a head start.
Oh, I thought, what?
A ute arrives, and both teams open their shed doors in anticipation.
All right, nice work. Hey, brilliant. You're making one toaster, Paigey. All right, don't worry about the world's resources. Two pieces of toast?
Yeah, how big's the toast, mate?
Hey.
Think about it. You're just jealous.
Is that it? Nice work.
Cool. Well, we'll just build something that will hold both bulbs so that we can test it.
Feeling real good about this, guys.
Finally, Murray is back, and Coleman and Chris eagerly bring all their materials into the shed.
Wow, cool.
Yeah,
this is good. This is good. Well done, Murray.
Without wasting time, they put together a frame to hold their blow torches so they can see just how fast their flames will toast the bread.
2, 4, 35, happy with that?
Yay.
Over in the other shed, Paige's team have already cobbled together a small rig for testing. They want to see what type of light will work best. A normal incandescent bulb or halogen.
It's toasting.
It is. Yeah, so currently halogen's winning.
The halogen bulb is the hottest, as the halogen gas inside combines with tungsten to create a heat much greater than a normal bulb.
Kill the bulb.
I think we have a clear winner.
Yeah, that. That's halogen. That's one bulb. I mean, we may even want to not use that many bulbs, because if we use four, we might just scorch it, because that's actually, like, it proved right.
Get your pilot lights going.
Coleman's team are also about to test their style of toasting, but their method is a little more haphazard.
Go.
Their aim is to find out how long they need to blast the toast with fire without turning it to charcoal.
So try that.
Do I have to right now? See, that's almost like it.
It stinks. It stinks.
I'm not really looking forward to eating toast, butter, jam and petrol.
I'll leave that up to the health and safety officer says I can.
OK? Yeah, I think there's a whole lot of unburnt petroleum that's going through, and we'll just tell Chris to get hard.
3, 2, 1, go.
Sorry. Oh, I'd be happy anywhere between 5 and 2 seconds, which is probably it's where we're looking, really, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're like, bang, 2, 3, 4, chinch, bang, 2, 3, 4, bang, 2, 3, 4, step, ball, change, step, and. Right. Okay. Well, we'd better get into the build quickly.
Having both tested their toasting methods, the teams get into building the actual machines, with everyone lending a hand in their own special way.
It's like a flash dance, you know. You're welding, I'm dancing, you know, in the background.
You never seen that movie?
No.
Okay. Don't worry about it.
The team's toasters are slowly coming together. Their challenge is to cook and eat four slices of toast as quickly as possible. Paige's team are working on a giant spatula-like cradle that the bread will sit in.
Pinch point is there, and that should swing around through.
While Coleman is trying to create an ignition to spark the LPG into flame that will toast the bread, and has chanced his arm at some amateur electronics.
What I thought was, instead of trying to fiddle around with the lighters, I've got the barbecue lighters that we've got here. I've taken them apart. So you've got this, and obviously if you notice when I do that, this is the little sparky bit.
Oh,
bang.
Oh, you got
spark,
it sorted.
Yep, spark jumps across there.
Yep.
So if we can...
You got two of those?
Yep, got two of those.
Yeah, cool.
If we can rig this up so that we get a spark jumping across, say, down near the cool end of the this gas jet, and then we can, well, just come down, start it up, bang.
James just doesn't seem to be too concerned about safety. I think he thinks the goggles is just to make him look cool.
Gee, that gives a fair belt, doesn't it?
If I was to give James some life coaching advice, maybe slow down a little bit, eh? He's always on the go. He's not thinking about things sometimes. He just jumps straight in.
Paige is helping Andre ready the board for the bulbs while keeping the working atmosphere light.
I can smell your cologne.
You shouldn't laugh, man.
No, seriously. Nervous, dude.
No.
Greg, of course, as mad as a hatter. But good fun.
Yeah, well, you know, the last electrician I had in here, I ate his liver with some fava beans and a nice Chianti.
Coleman and Murray are struggling with the contraption that will insert the bread into the flame.
Hey, have we welded this stuck?
Yeah.
Oh, I think, we've probably just gone.
But it's nothing a bit of angle grinding can't fix.
Can we grind that out?
What are we hitting now?
We're stuck.
Okay, we're touching something.
There it is. Away. Go.
Meanwhile, Paige has put his electrical technician Andre to work, who is wiring up a large group of halogen bulbs.
So about a kilowatt, just under.
Yeah.
And that's going to be that one panel alone. Just 12. No, six. That's one. And we're making one that's 12. So it's 12 of these, open,
essentially,
close.
Yeah.
I've never connected that many lights together in one go. It's interesting.
Your power bill would be like, be about $2,000 a month. That'd be fantastic. I'm just making toast.
Having sorted out the bread applicator, Coleman pulls out their cumbersome contraption for testing.
Bloody hell!
Oh, you're right. I'll load the toast up. Yes, yeah. Great.
Let's go.
Okay.
Ignition.
Right. Okay, fire them right up. Okay, here we go. Toast looks all right.
Yeah, well, it's toasted.
That's
evenly toasted.
Yeah.
Evenly toasted.
It's good. We've got that jamming problem that I didn't think about, which, of course, it makes sense really when you think about it.
It seems that we've slightly miscalculated the size, so what we need to do is somehow hold that bread up while it's in that position.
It's connected to this, comes down, and drops onto that.
That's it.
Yes. That's all we need to do. Let's get it back in. I'll take this in, mate.
You sure?
Seriously.
Good progress for Coleman's team, but they set straight to fixing their jamming toast problem. Paige is ready to test his spring-loaded bread cradle. They're going to toast all four bits of bread at once.
Right.
Okay, we'll go two brown, two white.
Perfect.
Three, two, one. If you can make that with a little eyelet so it stays on
say,
there.
Because where's it gone?
Yeah.
That's the problem.
Just try that toast, make sure that we're happy that fit in there.
Yeah. Okay.
And while Coleman's team have fixed their jamming toast, Paige is fixing to cause trouble.
Hey, bro, what are you doing?
quick, just drag it inside.
With playtime over, the teams knuckle down and get back into their builds. Time is running out and Pagey hasn't even started the build of his body. His team have one more test to see whether Andre's electrical wall of power-hungry halogen bulbs will work.
Are you good to go?
Yep.
Kendall, it's time. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Yes! That is fantastic.
What the?
That is so... Whoa, it's so bright.
I can feel it from back here.
Yeah.
Go and see what's going on over there.
I quite like it.
We've still got a whole other one to go down here as well.
Hey, it's right said Fred.
What are you doing?
What are you doing, man?
What's this?
It's a toaster.
Paige blew the fuse.
With the power back on, both teams get to work on the bodies of their designs, preparing for the big challenge in the morning.
I can't wait to get it going. Can't wait to get it loaded up with bread.
It is the day of the big challenge, and the teams are happy with their toasters. Murray from Coleman's team is confident and making bold predictions about the competition.
I think we're going to win easily. This thing, we've just got so much power, we can just ramp that up. We can probably cook toast in under a second, I just about believe.
But both teams are cocky about their toasting inventions. In fact, Andre is characteristically upbeat.
Oh, we'll win.
The challenge? To cook and eat 4 pieces of toast in the fastest time possible. To be judged once again by the adjudicator.
It's hardly the most environmentally friendly challenge, Paige, is it? You're going to drain the national grid and we're going to use a couple of bottles of LPG to make 4 beautifully cooked pieces of toast.
Mm. You and your bro and my dad built a scaffolding rig in your kitchen that burns stuff.
Let's go, Paige. You ready?
Yep.
Yeah! Right. Good luck.
Yep. Away you go, mate. Take that with you. You may need it. In fact, you will need it.
Team Coleman? On your marks, get set, go!
Coleman's team load their contraption with bread, hoping the previous problems they've had with their applicator have been sorted.
All right.
Ready.
Turn up the heat, turn up the heat. That's it, now we're moving.
Murray aids the toasting manually, passing the finished piece onto the life coach Chris to eat. The applicator and flames are working quickly. Chris's mouth isn't. He's struggling to eat the LPG-flavoured bread.
Last one!
All the bread is toasted. Chris now needs to put his life coach skills into practice and dissolve all of his negative feelings if he is going to complete his toast-eating task.
Oh, there we go.
The team's time now depends on him.
That's it!
There and the crust as well!
Can't eat the crust! He's joking! Right? Hit him on the back! He's got a bit of crust in his throat! More water! Water! Oh, stop! That's it!
A draining experience for Chris, whose throat really didn't come to the party, slowing his team down and giving Pagey's team a real chance.
That was great.
Team Pagey, on your marks, get set, go.
All right, okay, good man. Load the device.
Coming in.
Arm the device. Trigger's on.
Ready.
Right.
Go. Start the cooking.
Keep going, bring the banks up, and we are cooking.
Paige's bread is locked and loaded. Good. Now they just need to wait and let the halogens do their work.
Not a lot happening.
Is it starting to go brown?
Browning, yep. We're looking good, we're looking really good. Really good. Nice. Even browning, lovely. Lovely.
Is there anything happening?
I can smell it.
Yep, it's browning up nicely. I just want to get it perfect. I don't want to undercook it, because you know, you've got to do your toast just right.
We are.
Here we go. Off for the power.
Ready.
Firing the device.
Morning, dear.
The toast is done. Pagey has backed his own big mouth for the eating task ahead. In a controversial move, he's decided to crush up the toast, making it easier and faster to eat.
Jesus!
I didn't know that was glass.
Pagey has added an unexpected element to the challenge, removing glass from the toast.
Idiot!
Avoiding the glass and applying liquid, Pagey gets down to the eating, while trying not to bring it back up.
The water's down here.
Man needs a drink.
Yourself.
Very angry, man.
Swallow it, Pagey.
I'll break that as well.
Come on.
Come on, man, we've been timed. Finish it, come on. That's awesome.
Boom!
Time. Woo!
Yeah!
Oh, yeah!
You guys rule. I left my broom in the shed.
Who's going to clean that up?
I'll clean that up when I come home from work, honey.
Maybe not the cleanest way to eat breakfast, but is it the quickest?
What were you doing?
We were going to make a tortilla of toast by hammering it flat. It's kind of...
The results are in. So, Team Coleman cooked and ate 4 pieces of toast in 3 minutes and 42 seconds. Team Pagey cooked and ate 4 pieces of toast and a bit of glass in 3 minutes and 16 seconds.
Yes!
Pagey takes it out, a 4-slice toaster toasting by light. But if you've got a massive kitchen, need your toast fast, and have no aversion to fire, then the choice between the two is purely personal.
You took your hammer and you smashed your glass table.
I made a tortilla of toast.
There was a point when we were watching, I saw that hammer come up, I thought, no!
I just had a moment of breakfast mayhem, I just forgot it was
glass.
Guys,
it's a damn good effort. You know what?
It looks fantastic.
I'd rather have that in my kitchen than your thing. You know that? You spill your coffee on that, you're done. You're toast. I mean, seriously. I'm going to have a session with my life coach because I'm not coping with this. Now, what'll I do?
This is Coleman. He loves beeping things up and watching them explode. This is Pagey. He's a motor mouth with an eye for detail. And their wits, brains and talents are about to be tested in a classic face-off. It's early Saturday morning, and Coleman and Pagey are about to be given a bland, boring household appliance. They have 48 hours to try and make it bigger, better, faster, and stronger.
Oh, yeah. There's nothing worse than a piddling shower.
This is one of the most luxurious showers on the market, but some scientists think that the climate is changing, and they are now saying that it is irresponsible to have 20-minute, high-powered showers. You have a weekend to create a shower that cleans the body, but uses the least amount of water possible. Oh, you must nominate one person from your team to go in the shower for the challenge.
Paige. Good.
Good luck. I'm going to come out of the shower now. Can you pass me a towel?
Come out.
Thanks.
Pagey, good luck.
You need it.
This is going to be
fun.
This is going to be a steamy
it's
old
be
challenge.
Really good fun, I think.
Now Coleman and Pagey have to choose some team members to help them build their showers. Each one of these team members has a specific talent that'll be helpful to the task at hand. Except one, the wild card, whose special talent is not at all helpful. This week, there is a steam engineer, a plumber, a handyman, a motor technician, and the wild card, a cheerleader.
I choose you.
All right. Yeah. Shower challenge chooses the girl.
All right, then. Show us what's on your T-shirt.
Oh, yes. Cheerleader.
Yes.
I'm in Team New Zealand, which competes over at the Worlds.
I'm going to choose a man with an excess of hair. Let's see what you got.
Yeah! Awesome.
I can offer my expertise in how to plumb out a shower and make it a bit more exciting with putting a few jets in.
Now I'm going to go for the gentleman on the end.
Whoa, steam engineer.
That's good.
I was pretty excited by the whole concept and I can bring a little bit of flavour to it.
And it's just going to be 50-50. I'm going with this man.
see what you got. Motor technician. Phantom. Read that pagey and weep.
Yeah, I like building crazy vehicles like choppers and adapting minis for the wrong purpose of what they were built for.
Oh, well.
Who did we miss out on? Handyman.
You actually had that kind of handyman look about you, but
damn it.
I just thought it'd be too obvious. Come meet the shed, guys.
Welcome to the team, Coleman.
You can carry the silver scroll of
the teams now only have the weekend to make a shower that cleans someone while using the least amount of water possible.
You know, even though it's a challenge, I don't want to have one of those showers that just, you know, the trickles out.
I mean, steam would be a wicked idea.
Yeah, it's got to be warm.
But steam doesn't steam, like, peel your skin off, like.
Well, the great thing about steam is we're just going to be boiling a jug or something and using very little water. We're distilling it at the same time, so it's pure water, cleaner than a shower, better for your hair, better for your skin. What we're talking here is going to rock.
We could recycle the water.
Yes.
And we're going to have to pump it to get it back to recirculate it, you know?
They're using their own juice.
Yeah.
No, you can't.
Well, it's no worse than a bath, but
we need something on top to keep the heat in.
I think we've got to take the girls' opinion on the shower because they spend most time in them, so we can rock with that.
Actually, I have to confess to you, man, I spend like
I did hours. Hear. I did hear.
This needs to be the sand filter?
Yes.
Yep.
Doesn't it? And then
Coleman wants to have a high-pressure shower with heaps of water, but is going to recycle any water used. His shower will be raised with the wastewater running down through a sand filter, cleaning the water as it passes back into a hot water cylinder. The water will be taken from this cylinder via a water blaster, pumping it back up through the shower head and the jets.
To make steam, we've got to boil water. It'll be 100 degrees, but when we mix it with the cold air on there, or the air in the room, a bit of moisture, we'll be hard-pressed to get 40 or 50.
Well, why don't we use hair dryers that have a temperature on them so we can control the temperature.
Pagey's team will essentially be creating a steam cloud. Using a sealed shower, they will introduce a fine mist through atomizing nozzles. At the same time, hair dryers will pump in hot air, warming the shower but cooling the mist, creating condensation and using a minuscule amount of water.
So I just got a shopping list.
The teams write up their shopping lists of all the things they need to get.
Yeah. Shampoo.
Not for you.
Shut up!
Coleman's team is out first, and he sends Rob out to get all of the equipment.
See you, mate.
Bede is not far off.
Good. Go safe.
Yeah, away you go.
Leaving both teams with nothing to do but sit in their sheds.
Let's all save water and shower like you order. Paige's team's got the steam. And
to get out there and slaughter James Coleman in his face with some mace.
Oh, God.
Like that?
Yeah, no, that's a bit too intense. Normal speed, ready? 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2.
That'll be the cheerleader.
One. Oh, wow.
I did an extra move.
Oh.
That's quite good.
The first ute is back, and the teams are keen to see who it is.
Ah, awesome.
It's Rob from Coleman's team. But Pagey doesn't seem to mind. He's happy to keep on cheering.
It's a bit sand.
Why don't we try something tricky? I want you to hit.
No, that was, yeah, okay, tricky.
Greg, as a cheerleader, would be kind of good. He's really enthusiastic.
I try to smile with my eyes. It's really hard. My teeth are drying up.
Good stuff, Rob. Well done. Got it, mate.
Push it out. Can we do it again? Do it again.
Ready?
Do it again.
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Half an hour later, and Bede is back.
Wait, hang on. Mate! Man, could you pass?
Pagey is anxious and begins biffing stuff towards the shed.
Fling it over there.
Coleman isn't far ahead. They've just begun to stack and measure to see how high their shower will be off the ground.
1600 off the ground.
Well.
What have I got in this ladder?
These are heavy and man-sized. Great, I'll take these.
Yeah. There's our shower, right there. It's perfect.
Let's
move this one around. So
yeah, we're gonna put the desks back, kind of.
Why they were moved around? What have you been doing?
Oh, nothing. We're just sweeping.
Yeah, nothing much.
What's this for?
I don't know.
I guess it's.
Once Pagey has everything in, they get straight to work on making the box that will house the hair dryers for their hot air blower.
Okay, so there's our hair dryers going in.
That keeps the scent out of our system. Put that in, tighten it up, and then put that on the inside and just tape it because the weight of the gravel, it's not going to
push
move,
it in.
Is it?
Yeah, yeah.
You,
know
true, you can true. Double it up if you want.
Yeah, something like that. Just make it work, should we?
Right.
Coleman's team is already testing.
Okay.
Right, let's do it.
They want to make sure their filter system will flow freely and clean the water properly. They also need to make sure that the sand will stay in the filter and not get into the pumps, which will clog and damage the whole system.
I mean, the sand is very fine, so I might, we should start with two and then may double it up afterwards.
Okay.
Give it the best shot.
All right, in goes the fine sand on top of that.
The pump into the
filter.
Water.
Boom. In comes the water.
Right. Ready?
You switch it on.
Yep.
You have a
pumps
kitchen.
On.
You should be getting more.
Any water?
No, we'll come. We're just waiting for a bit of pressure.
There it comes. Whee! At this point, I'm kind of worried, actually.
Me too.
Yeah, the floor.
Because that is not a great amount of flow. In fact, that's pathetic. Hey.
Well, that was around about a minute of shower, was it?
Let's get back to the drawing board.
Oh, okay, we have to do something.
While Coleman's team try to figure out how to filter their water, Paige's team keep building and sharing.
When you finish with that, if there's any tools that I'm allowed to use, it would be pretty cool.
Hey,
that's better.
Team spirit.
After half a day, the teams are beginning to gel, and Paige's project is coming along nicely. They are looking to make a shower that can clean a person while using the least amount of water possible.
They let me have a go at everything, which is really cool to, you know, use all the different tools that I wasn't quite familiar with. Oh, look, I've got a suit. Yeah, it was a good learning experience.
Aha! Success!
No. Sabrina's been awesome. She's keen to just get in, get stuck in and help. Point her in the right direction, she's away.
But misplaced tools mean things have slowed in Coleman's shed.
Couldn't find a square.
I know we've got a square up there. See, I left it up there. Paige has come in here and stolen my square. Light-fingered little Paige. Paige!
I've
got a set square missing from my shed. Where is it?
Hey, how you going?
What have you done? Have you done anything?
Yeah, well,
it's coming along fine.
Great, good. Can I just grab that? Where have you put the T-square?
Yeah. Don't take any of my tools.
I need
they're
some
all
vice grips. I need a monkey wrench.
No.
Where's the set square?
Sign those out at the door.
I feel good about ours now. That's excellent.
Bring that back.
Now he knows all our secrets.
Ah, yes, please. Very nice.
Ignoring the interruption, Paigey continues working on adjustments to his shower.
Flip it.
Okay.
These fell inside. Nice. That's wickedly straight.
I think I swallowed some.
Time for Coleman to test another filter system and see if they can sort out one of the most important parts of their design.
It's better, but it's still not the flow we want, is it?
Nah.
Hang on, plan B. What about we get this and put it straight on there? Okay, wire it on
that?
There.
That's coming out of the bottom of the shower.
Yeah.
Yes.
Put that on there, fill it with sand, and then let it go through here, pour out of there, we'll hope, into there. You know what I mean? Like.
Oh, so what you've got, essentially, is you've got...
Two separate filters.
You've got sand or whatever crap coming through out of the nozzle into the shower.
Yes.
Down the plug hole.
Yep.
Filters here.
Yes.
Yes.
Before it goes back into the coarse filter.
Yeah.
More surface area.
That's a bloody good idea, Alan.
It's the last one.
That's a bloody good idea. Let's get cutting.
All right. Let's get cracking here.
I'd have to take the top off that.
Meanwhile, Paige's team have been working quickly and have managed to finish their hot air blower.
I got a good feeling about this.
Well, this box that we've just kind of constructed should pump the heat into the shower, so whoever's going to be in the shower is not going to freeze to death.
These hair dryers will introduce hot air into the shower to mix with the fine water spray and create condensation.
Oh my gosh, it's working!
Yeah. Oh yeah, it's quite nice.
It's quite nice.
Turn them down.
Okay,
done.
Shut them down.
Yep. Now we have to make sure that
get that out.
Oh, yeah, get that out. Hey!
Good job.
Dodgy!
Looks like an outhouse.
What do you reckon? Can you work out what it is?
Your naughty chair.
It's a massive throne.
Are you using that?
You can have that, Paigey. How's your poor cheerleader getting on? I hope you're looking after
her. She's actually one of the finest machinists I've seen in a long time.
Really?
Yep.
Well, good luck.
Oh, mate, we don't need luck. We've got science and technology on our side. See ya.
Very good. OK. See ya, Paigey.
With their shower nearing completion, Paigey's team is now dealing with the tough part of the challenge. Who will take the shower?
You're smaller than me. I mean, it's makes scientifically sense. It's smarter to put the smallest person in because there'd be less dirt to clean off.
Man, it's going to be a tall shower.
Having figured out the filter troubles, Coleman and Alan have worked quickly on making the frame that will hold their shower off the ground. They are keen to see if it will hold the weight of a person and if the water catcher will work with the filter.
Should we test it out?
All right,
I'll get up here in the shower.
We need something like that. Can you work the pump, man?
Yep,
Rob.
Go ahead, Rob. Ignition. That sock's working great. That's really good.
Very good.
Awesome.
You want to have a good shower, will you, James? I mean, you're the person who will be standing in it.
I tell you what, Rob, if the amount of water that's coming out the bottom of that bucket
yes.
is the amount of water that's coming out of all the nozzles
yes.
and it's warm, I will take a shower.
Right. No worries. You want to have a comfortable shower.
Just going to unkink the hose. What are you doing?
No, it's fixed, honest. Behave, we've got visitors.
Wow, man. You look like a tiny midget on a giant toilet.
Right. It's not that funny.
Here.
Tiny Coleman.
Come closer.
Tiny Coleman.
Come closer. Oh,
there you go.
Get it back inside.
Ooh.
Wow, that's great. It works beautifully.
Yeah.
Yep, very happy. Cool.
Look what I mean.
Paigey is building the base for his shower.
We'll put the waste at the front so we can show off to James how little wastewater we actually have.
So I think we put a dummy pipe there and we just waste it out the back.
Exactly.
What we want to do is cover every angle of the body and we need something that comes...
From there.
Ow.
Oh, well done.
Having sorted out the filter system, Coleman's team work on the various jets. These will shoot the water at the person showering.
We wouldn't want the full pressure out of that one, would we? We might want to make that one a bit...
Well, the smaller we go, the more pressure we get.
The amount of pressure coming out of that jet may hurt in places where you not want to be hurt.
Right, let's get this thing up on the frame.
The top of Paigey's shower is ready to test. The atomizers turn the water into a fine spray, meaning the volume of water is considerably less. They're hoping this spray will mix with the hot air created by their hair dryers and create a steam cloud.
All right, I'm ready. Yeah. I'll start out here in case it's really harsh. Oh, look at that! Look at that. It's great.
Yeah.
It feels really nice, actually. It's really soft. Yeah, it looks like really, it's really...
Oh, it's so...
It could be quite nice to stand under and make the whole kind of shower experience a lot better than we thought it would be.
You have to hold your breath for the entire length of your shower. Oh.
Shut it down.
Yeah.
We're good. We are really good.
Let them see
too much. Paigey's spray worked well, but a lot of water has been used. Coleman has a lot more building to do than Paigey, but his time has been spent on recycling water. Paigey has the evening to figure out how to use less water, while Coleman just needs to finish his build.
Check it out.
Ooh.
Soap and a rope. Alan?
No.
It's good.
It's the day of the big challenge, and the team showers are ready to go. Their challenge is to clean a dirty person from head to toe while using as little water as possible. They have just 10 minutes, but it's all about water use. They will be watched and judged by the adjudicator.
I would hope we'd win, but we still haven't seen much of the other competitors' attempt yet. We're here to win. We're not here for the, you know, to be second.
I peeped through the other shed and I'm extremely confident because it looks like early models of the space shuttle.
What's that?
That's what you call the upper echelon of showers, Paigey.
It just looks like an inferno pyre.
Well, I'm getting in my shower as opposed to you, who've made Sabrina get in the shower.
Yeah, but so if you look at our body mass...
What a creep.
Sabrina's got the least body to get clean.
Oh, I see. You've been justifying
scientific.
This. You've been justifying this for 2 days. It's always been your plan. Are you ready?
Yep.
Yes. All right.
It's okay. You go first, mate.
Good luck.
I don't think you're going to breathe a bit.
Ooh. You ought to actually get
into your shower, mate.
Maybe some oxygen to
here. Let's go, guys. Go, Colvin.
On your marks. Get set. Go.
Right, okay.
Coleman carefully climbs his ladder and gets into the shower, while Alan starts the water blaster that will give the water high pressure.
Okay.
It's like an oil rig in the middle of a bathroom.
What's going on?
The water blaster is intermittent, meaning the water flow is a bit sputtery.
James, you've got to put petrol in it.
They're wasting a lot of time, and Coleman is still filthy.
Guys, congratulations.
Yeah, I think we just already got it.
Rob has a go to see if he can get the water blaster started. It bursts into life, and Coleman is hit with a torrent of water. He can now start showering. The water is coming out rapidly, both from the shower head, but also from the jets in the front. Coleman is getting an all-over body wash.
How's that? Am I done? Am I done?
With legs, with legs. Do your legs.
Oh, how's that?
Oh, oh, man.
That's it, that's it.
Hey, man, that was great.
I'm clean.
My dad's climbing out. Please look away.
Coleman is clean, and his shower is a real success. But the water blaster mishap cost them a lot of time, meaning if everything goes right, Sabrina won't need to spend as much time in the shower, hopefully meaning they won't use as much water.
Seriously? The whole colonic thing? Spot on? That was fantastic. Check the bag out. As far as I'm concerned, they didn't lose any water at all. That worked absolutely beautifully.
Team Pagey, on your marks. Get set. Go.
Go, B, go. You get up there. Well, don't get it until it's ready.
OK.
Wait till he's got them all going.
Oh, my God, it's coming.
B turns on all of the hair dryers. They are now transferring hot air into the shower. He now introduces the water. Sabrina waits for the water to heat up.
Go. Warm. Let it clear out. Let it clear out. It's going to get warm. It's going to get warm. Jump in. In you go. In you go. Yes. Top to bottom. Remember, start at the top. Good. Good. Yes. Yes. Keep going. That's good. On your back. Do your back. Do your back. Yep. That's good.
There's a bit of water there, Pagey.
It's not wasting that much at all.
The steam inside is growing as the wastewater is removed quickly from the shower. It all seems to be working well.
Let's. Beautiful. Almost, almost. What the hell? Do your booty. Do your booty.
Ooh, nice.
Stand there, there's a towel.
Well done. Well done. Good effort.
Sabrina is clean quickly, and Bede and Pagey celebrate in their own special way.
Oh, man hug too from the big man. Thank you.
All right, teams, results are in. So Team Coleman cleaned a human in the allotted time and used only 3.7 litres of water. Team Pagey cleaned a human in the allotted time and used 6.4 litres of water.
A win for Coleman, who used a very small amount of water. Quite possibly the perfect invention for the environmentally conscious consumer of the future.
I'm surprised you could breathe in there, Sabrina, actually.
I could.
Could you?
It's fine.
That's why she stayed in so long. You used 6 litres. She did her hair as well, though, and she shaved her legs.
Congratulations, Sabrina. Are you all right? Are you warm enough? Seriously, you guys have no idea what we went through. I mean, ours was always going to win because we didn't use any water.
Yeah, but you just use your own body fat to wash yourself, which makes people puke in their mouths.
In fact, I may have actually added to the water in the system, if you know what I'm talking about.
Supporting local content so you can see more of New Zealand on air.